Welcome.
How's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good.
I know you guys live close, but my old house was like literally right there.
Mm-hmm. Just a couple doors down.
This is totally different than I thought it was gonna look inside as far as the multiple levels.
Yeah.
All right, where do you guys wanna start?
The kitchen.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So in here, this is what we really need to change.
Okay. All right, how long have you guys lived here?
Since 2015.
2015.
Yeah.
Okay. And I can tell that the outside, the yard looks different than the inside.
Yeah. That was a remodel we did for the backyard probably 2 to 3 years ago.
Nice. First, let's start off with what you don't like. And then if you could have anything, what would it be?
I can go with what we don't like.
Okay.
Very dark. We need to lighten it up for sure. So every morning, we're trying to get the kids ready.
Yeah.
She's making lunches and really hard.
Who gets to move first?
No, you go. I'll go. So not very functional.
Traffic jam.
Traffic jam, for sure.
So you have to like run around the back.
Exactly. I'll go in a circle to meet you.
It's a race.
Yeah.
So we need to move this or at least get this out of here from our space just to walk by the fridge.
That's annoying.
I hate this wall so much.
Yeah.
Make it go away.
This wall.
Yeah.
Yes.
This whole wall.
Well, the fact that it's even here is a bit odd. I feel like it would be easy for it to come down because it's awkward. There's like this random space right here, like a runway.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. It's kind of a racetrack currently for our kids
to
chase each other.
I bet.
Yeah.
Okay, so what else are you guys thinking?
The counters kind of look dated and it's not us. The quality isn't really up to par. Like, it's so hard to pull out some of these drawers. I'm like,
I
don't know. And like, this is literally falling apart.
Yeah, this thing.
Oh, whoa.
Yeah.
Okay, so that makes sense.
I really want just like open concept.
Yep.
We host all the time, so people can't walk through. Like, just the flow does not go at all with like our lifestyle.
Exactly.
Totally.
And then since we want to make it more indoor, outdoor living, maybe we can make this door a bit longer.
Ooh, are you thinking?
Open it up.
Like bifold?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That would look awesome. It's probably gonna be 10, 12 feet. So yeah, you'd lose some of this, but then you would gain that flow that you're missing. Are you okay with losing the slider?
That's a tough one for me. I barbecue there all the time. And when we redid the outdoor area, we inserted that slider.
Oh.
So
it's new.
Yeah.
It's new-ish.
I get it. You guys just put it in. You don't want to take it out. Plus, you want to be able to have the indoor-outdoor flow from both sides of the kitchen.
Exactly.
Okay, we can make this work. Okay, here's what I'm thinking. Everything comes down.
Okay.
The wall comes down. This French door is going to go, and we're going to do that big, beautiful bifold door. Because the door is going to be about 10 to 12 feet, we are going to have to shift everything over, do a little bit smaller of a window. We'll have the sink looking out the window still. We'll have the dishwasher, some uppers and lowers, and some floating shelves alongside the window. We'll extend the kitchen on the other side of the slider here. And we'll do the refrigerator, some uppers and lowers, a slide-in range with a hood vent, some more uppers and lowers, and then the best part, we're gonna do a massive island. In the island, we'll have a ton of storage on the backside, and we can also do your microwave and a ton of bar seating.
Yeah.
Okay.
You'll have a beautiful entertainer's kitchen.
Okay.
Perfect.
Hey, Christina, what's up? It's Josh.
Hi, Josh.
We've got a massive mix-up over at Scott and Amy's right now.
That doesn't sound good.
Yeah, it's multiple items today all hitting at the same time. We're gonna have to figure this out. The pantry's undercut about 3 inches, so I'm gonna rework that. But the other massive issue we've got is all the flooring. I've got 35 boxes of that laminate flooring that was ordered on site here now. The planks look yellow, and we've gotta get this swapped out really fast. I've talked to Amy, she's on her way over here, but I'm pretty sure she's not gonna accept it.
Okay, I will get on the phone with James right now. We will call the distributor and we'll work on that as soon as possible.
Awesome, thanks so much, Christina.
All right, thank you.
Okay, bye.
We are 7 weeks into the project, and although the flooring issue will cause us a 2-week delay, Josh and his team are able to keep moving forward with other parts of the project.
looking good.
When I first walked in after not seeing it for a little bit, seeing the island, like,
crazy.
That's a good island. We were shocked at how much space we actually had in here. We never knew. Yeah. It was just
so cluttered.
The
ceilings look higher, like everything's changed.
It feels like a totally different house. So there's been some hiccups. It looks like we're back on track.
Yeah, I mean, we've had a handful of issues pop up. The pantry, the boxes were made a little undersized. We were able to get those rebuilt and back out here within about 2.5 days from when we found the problem. And then while we were looking at the floor and setting the cabinets, we found that we've got some additional issues with the floor now.
Huh?
Yeah.
What?
Basically, when we were setting this island cabinet the other day, we found out that your entire kitchen subfloor is sloping at about a 3% slope that direction. We're gonna come in and pour a product called Level Quick, and it'll allow for those areas to be flat from that point forward.
Sounds a little bit complicated, so I have to ask, is this gonna cost extra?
I do think it could run anywhere from $500 up to maybe $1,750 if it's real bad.
Okay.
I think at this point, like, you can tell it's gonna be phenomenal. So let's just keep ticking boxes and moving forward.
Totally.
And making things right. All right, guys. The big day is finally here. You guys ready?
Yes, so ready. I feel really excited and nervous.
Come on in.
I'm just excited to see the finished product. I know it's gonna look great.
Oh my gosh, Christina.
Our house looks awesome. It's totally a game changer.
And it's hard to believe that there used to be a wall here.
Totally.
Right?
It was so separated.
Seeing just the amount of open space, it's better than we could have ever expected.
He's gotten his like industrial railings going both sides.
Yeah, that was something that was kind of difficult in theory to match, and bringing the same ones that we had outdoor and putting them here, it looks beautiful. Went from such a tight space, it was just not roomy.
Now the kitchen's massive.
Everything will happen right here. Our kitchen was dated and dark and removed from every other room in the house. Now it's completely the opposite. I love everything about it.
I love the stove.
I love it too.
So beautiful, very classy.
I was never a hardware person. I just kind of let Amy run with that portion, but I love what she picked out. It looks great.
Me too.
I love all the pieces you chose. It just like makes it warmer.
And it's timeless. Like this style is truly a timeless style.
Yeah.
The white shaker, the brass, the pop of color in the island, the beautiful counters. So are you a big cook?
I mean, I'm probably like more of the cook here, so.
Cause I like how you have this little like prep area right now.
Honestly, I'm so excited about all of this and being able to like look out that way. Like we can do dishes over there, but this wall that was here was just so difficult for me to be in both rooms and watch everyone downstairs.
Now we're cooking and watching the kids at the same time.
Yeah.
You can see the TV down
It's just like perfect.
And the fact that we're able to do such a massive island, I love how we have everything in there. We have the beverage fridge, we have the ice maker, we have the trash.
I know.
We have the steam oven.
I wanted to line everything up and get all of the little features involved.
I'm an ice maker girl and a beverage fridge, so I can appreciate it.
All right, thank you.
Yep, I feel you.
It's beautiful.
So what do we think about these?
So good. We redid this backyard. We didn't use it as often as we thought we would.
Yep.
So now it's like this open concept, like way more open.
Yeah, this is amazing.
It changes it.
We always wanted that indoor-outdoor, like the California vibe.
Yep.
And putting this together and seeing these doors, it just pops.
Totally.
It makes our whole kitchen look so much better and combines like the indoor-outdoor feel.
Get one for everyone.
Going into it, we had a little bit of an idea in mind of what we wanted to do, and they really took our feedback and changed it 10 times better.
The sliding door, it brings in so much light.
Definitely the double doors. I think those are huge game changers, both upstairs and downstairs. It really just opens up the house, makes it so much more inviting, brighter, better for hosting. Cheers.
The whole thing is just like kudos to them because we couldn't have done it without them.